push off and sitting while in order smite the sounding furrows for my purpose holds the sail beyond the sunset and the paths of all the western stars until I die. Now these lines are representing the mariners, the companions of Ulysses, his peers. Push off and sitting well in order, smite the surrounding furrows. Ulysses is requesting or ordering his mariners, his companion, his peers to sit on the ship because they are going to make a new journey to discover a whole new world that they had never discovered until they die. Before they died, they must have to fulfill their desire of adventure and journey. Though this birth is not sufficient to complete the desire of adventure, the desire of traveling, but what they have now, they can fulfill their hearts with joy and pleasure by adventure and traveling. By offering the rest of their life, though they have become old and weak, their will and determination is much more stronger than their weakness of physical body. Push off and sitting well in order, smite the sounding furrows. For my purpose holds the sail beyond the sunset and the paths of all the western stars. Ulysses is not only saying his companions to be ready for the new journey, but he is also determining the goals of their journey. He is determining the aims of their journey, that this journey will continue until they die. They had to discover all the things they had never exposed before. They had to acquire knowledge and experiences a lot beyond the bound of human thought. The sounding furrows for my purpose holds the sail beyond the sunset. They have to sail beyond the sunset. And the paths of all the western stars, they have to travel all the western countries, all the western stars until I die, until he dies, until Ulysses dies. He has to cover all the western stars, western countries, because he is fond of traveling western countries and experience and observe the culture, language, people, climates, and many things of the western isles. It may be that the gulfs will wash us down. It may be we shall touch the happy isles. These two lines represents the positivity in the mind, the strong will and determination of Ulysses. He says it may be that the gulfs will wash us down. There may be the possibility that the gulfs will wash them down during their journey, at the times of their journey of traveling. that many problems, many obstacles may come on their way, or it may be we shall touch the happy isles, or it may be possible that they will be able to touch the happy isles, they will be able to, they, or they would be able to, they would be able to enter the happy isles. Happy isles is the paradise according to the Greek mythology. They believed, the people of the Greek mythology, according to the belief of the Greek mythology, that the heroes enter the happy isles. Happy isles is the paradise. So it may be possible, it might be possible that they could touch the happy isles and see the great Achilles whom we knew, and in the happy isles they could see the great Achilles, the hero whom we knew, whom they knew. Though much is taken, much abides, and though we are not now that strength which in old days moved earth and heaven. Too much is taken that they suffered much, much abides, and also they enjoyed much. And though we are not now that strength which in old days, that though they had no strength, they had no strength and energy as they had in their young age, because they had become old and they were physically weak, but it did not matter. It did not matter because they had the strong will. Ulysses had the strong will and determination, moved earth and heaven, that which we are. In the old days, they could also move earth and heaven, they could do hard labor, that which we are. Ulysses says, what they are, that means he and his companions, that is, they are the explorer, adventurer, traveler, they are. And they are that, and this identity and these identities would always be with them, because their determination and will is very strong. They are not exhausted only because of their old age or physical weakness. They are strong in mind and will. Their desire is strong and positive. One equal temper of heroic hearts, made weak by time and fate, but strong in will. One equal temper of heroic hearts. They have the hearts of equal temper, that is the heart of heroism. Their hearts are not weak hearts. Though they are physically weak, they have become old, but they are strong, quite strong, because of their heroic hearts. Their hearts are young and heroic. Made weak by time and fate, but strong in will. Though they have been made weak by time and fate, because they have become old, or because of the old age, but strong in will, but they are very strong in their will to strive, to seek, to find and not yield. The final, the ultimate, most significant line of the dramatic monologue, Ulysses. To strive, to seek, to find and not yield. They have to strive, they have to seek, they have to find, they have to discover, they have to explore, they have to expose, they have to acquire knowledge and experience, they have to experience and not yield. And they have not yield, they have to discover with quiet silence and in the pattern of wiseness, wisdom. So it is the dramatic monologue by Alfred Tennyson. The main theme, the main point, viewpoint of the dramatic monologue is the heroism of Ulysses, his heart of traveling and adventure, his desire of exploring, exposing the new world, his ambition of traveling and adventure, his business in traveling. Though he has become old, though he has become weak physically, but mentally and psychologically he is very strong in will. So no obstacle in the way of Ulysses can defeat him, because he is the man of strong will and determination. Thank you for watching this video. I hope you like the video. Please hit the like button. If you have any query, please comment on the comment below in the comment section. And also don't forget to subscribe and share, because your supporting is at most essential. You always enjoy many other videos in YouTube and waste your valuable time, but I'm trying to make you updated by making such educational videos. So please don't hesitate to support us and don't hesitate to subscribe to our channel. Thank you once again for giving your valuable time. Have a nice day. God bless you.